अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म अ एक्टिविटी टू शो दैट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज इवॉल्व्ड इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन। एंड फॉर दिस एक्टिविटी हियर यू कैन सी वी रिक्वायर्ड दिस मटीरियल। मटीरियल्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस प्रैक्टिकल इज स्प्राउटेड बीन्स। Here you can see in this dish there are pellets of potassium hydroxide. We need a bent tube to pass gas, a conical flask, rubber cork, spoon and test tube. And on this test tube we have to tie a thread. First, what we need to do, we have to soak beans. Either we can take moong, matki, these beans we have to soak in a water overnight and then keep them on a wet cotton cloth if we will keep them, what will happen, they will get sprouted. So here you can see the sprouted beans already. We need to place these sprouted beans in a conical flask. So here we will took a conical flask, and in this conical flask we have to put few sprouted beans. Here we are adding this matki in this conical flask. After we take the sprouted beans in a conical flask, second, what we need to do, we have to take a pellets of potassium hydroxide in a test tube. So we need to take a potassium hydroxide pellets here in a test tube. We can even use aqueous solution of potassium hydroxide. After taking the potassium hydroxide pellets in this test tube, we have to place this test tube in a conical flask. Okay, now we have to put this test tube where? In a conical flask where we already took those sprouted beans. So we have to carefully place a test tube in a conical flask. In this way we have to keep a test tube, and the mouth of that test tube is open. Okay, here you can see inside that test tube there is a sprouted beans and there is a test tube, and inside the test tube there is a potassium hydroxide pellets. Now over this, what we have to do, we have to tightly fit rubber cork with bent tube. Okay, here we have placed a rubber cork and now we have to insert a bent tube. Here on this bent tube you can see there are two ends. One is the smaller end and another one is the larger end. So the smaller end we have to insert in a rubber cork. Here in a conical flask we have to insert that smaller end, and we have to make sure that our apparatus is airtight. Okay, it should not be loose, it should be airtight. We can use even a petroleum jelly also to make it airtight, or a sellotape we can tie on the mouth of this conical flask. And then we have to insert the second end of a test tube. This second end, the larger end, we have to insert in a beaker. And here in this beaker, what is there? Here you can see we took a colored water in this beaker. Okay, why we took a colored water? So that we can easily mark a water level in that bent tube, as we need to measure the water level in a bent tube. Now initially what we need to do, after we inserted a large end of a bent tube in a beaker, we have to mark an initial level of water. So here with the help of a marker we will, here you can see there is a water level. Okay, that point was a water level initially. Now we have to mark that water level in a bent tube, and then we have to keep our apparatus, our setup, we have to keep it as it is for 5 to 10 minutes. After 5 minutes, here you can see that water level is slightly rising. The water level is increasing. Level of water is slowly increasing here. Here you can see the water level is slightly more as compared to the initial one. So what it indicate, what it show? It shows that the carbon dioxide is evolved during respiration, is absorbed by KOH, that is potassium hydroxide, and therefore the water level in a vent tube rises. So here in our observation, what we have to write? We have to write that carbon dioxide evolved in respiration is absorbed by KOH. Therefore, the water level in a vent tube rises. Inference, or what is a conclusion? As the carbon dioxide gas is evolved. And why this carbon dioxide gas is evolved? Because those germinated seeds, those sprouted seeds, they respire aerobically, okay, and they releases carbon dioxide. And what is the use of that potassium hydroxide? That potassium hydroxide will absorb carbon dioxide which releases during respiration process. And due to this, what will happen when the carbon dioxide will absorb? Then there will be a low pressure which will build in a conical flask, and due to that reduce in a pressure, water level in a vent tube will rise in slowly. So this proved that the carbon dioxide is evolved in the process of respiration. Thank you everyone.